see what I can do.
To listen to that crap no more.
Shit. Wait. What did you do? You shot up his generator and killed his radio uplink, didn't you?
Goddamn right I did. Now none of us have to listen to that shit. Fucking radio-free Oregon bullshit. Now it's Copeland-free Oregon.
Stupid asshole. What do you think, he's gonna let that fly? Dumb shit.
What do you mean?
Bastard's probably got a price on our head already. And now we know just where to look.
I didn't think that...
But you got something right for once in your shitty life. You didn't think. You didn't think when you got caught stealing fish or when you beat that man to death.
You ate the goddamn fish, same as us.
Jesus, Billy. I didn't know you stole it, killing a man.
Cope cut our rations. Ray and I, we weren't thinking straight. We were...
You were being a couple dumbasses. Now look at us. We had a good thing going there. Yeah, Cope's a stupid son of a bitch, but he ain't no murderer.
I'm sorry, Joe.
Not yet, you ain't. Cope sends someone out here, then you might be.
So we're going back and killing the son of a bitch, am I right?
Jesus, Billy, shut the hell up!
I was just asking. Who was that?
Get away!
Last of them. Jesus, Cove. How many men have you pissed off? All right. This has got to be the generator, but it's been shot to hell. Okay. That should do it. There we go. If you had bullets, I wouldn't be breathing now, would I?
Please, mister.
I don't shoot women if I have a choice. Do I have a choice?
I ain't got nothing. I got nowhere to go.
All right, let's see if they got an underground bunker around here. Here's the hatch. Yeah, I knew you had one. Hello, a map. Looks like they marked it up pretty good.
Deke, you there? Probably nothing. Sounded like bike engines, riding somewhere on the mountain.
I just finished clearing the radio tower for Copeland. I'm gonna climb the tower, see if I can see anything.
Deke, you okay? You don't sound like yourself.
It's nothing. You know, I just let this drifter get the drop on me. Lucky for me, she was out of ammo.
You let her go, didn't you?
Okay. Yeah, fuck. Yes, I let her go.
One of these days, Deke, that code of yours is gonna get you killed.
Yeah, well, something's gonna do it, right? Does it matter what? Deacon out. Jesus, what a climb. All right, let's see what the hell Boozer's talking about. We're right. Someone's on the mountain. I see smoke from their campfire.
Oh, son of a bitch. I knew I heard something. Where are they? I'm gonna head out there.
No, god damn it, Boozer. Gotta get your arm healed up so we can ride the hell out of here. I'll take care of him.
Shit. It's just... I'm going a little stir crazy here, Dick.
Just try to stay awake in case they head your way. Deacon out. Jesus, I gotta get in shape. Almost there. Yeah, come on, keep going. Almost there. Oh, shit's killing me. I got a use for you. Can you use this? St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down. I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. You may not see the value in St. John, but Radio Free Oregon is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
No, Cope, the only thing keeping us from turning into savages is about 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're Copeland out.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done?
Booze man, you awake? I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. It might be an ambush camp.
Find out when I get there. Deacon out.
Deke, you got your radio on? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Boozer, thank you. Yeah, I'll stop by when I can. Deacon out. Booze man, you were right. They set up along the railroad tracks.
Kill every one of the sons of bitches.
That was kind of the plan. Deacon out.
Okay.
That's the last of them.
Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain.
Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out.
You don't need these.
Good now.
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find my aunt's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride. Booze Man, no. You know I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
I'll take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out. So close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how. Oh, here we go. That's it. they can't get you now. Angel, this has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? What do we got? Maybe in one of these.
Boozman, are you listening? No, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Nice headshot.
Down you go! Whoa, hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Researcher, what the hell are we doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet. Throw a rock. That ought to distract them.
It's taking forever.
If they see me, I'm dead.
Forever's a long time.
Starting to rain. Might bring these things in.
Shit.
It's freezing out.
Check the thermo in your suit.
Got everything you need.
Stay in the shrubs. They can't see me in there.
Shit.
Heat on in your suit? After tracking a large brooding group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
It's nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Can't you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
They're sleeping like babies. And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling. These suits protect you from a lot of shit, but not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See the caves. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Wasn't even my turn on the duty roster.
Complain to the CO. Do I look like the CO?
It's over, farewell. That was a lot of goddamn freakers.
Yeah. A few dozen at least.
Hope we got enough fuel to get back. Going all over hell and back today.
But fuel is the least of our problems when we're on the ground. Just stay focused. Now.
Okay, stay low, stay low.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke.
Hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't...
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. Fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find him.
Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows in this great country? People living on the streets in boxes and tents because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country, only to have the feds forget about them as soon as they were done with them. PTSD doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now, living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never gonna give us that. And you? You want our trust? You gotta earn it. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great! Yeah, Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again! Oh, God, what have I done?
Scrap. Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother. She do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deacon out. There we go. Okay. Yes. Another nest zone. I gotta burn this shit down, make it safer. Later, burn out these nests.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most have spoke out against the feds. Well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland from Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
deer crossing. Wow, that's not too smart without the traffic. I gotta burn them out. I gotta make it safer to ride. Don't worry, fellas. I'll be back later. Finish burning you out.
Open up, it's that drifter.
Where's Tucker? Alki.
Over at the dig site.
Well, which one, goddammit?
The north one. Back there.
Anybody touches this bike, or anything on it, I break your fingers.
Whatever, man. Jesus.
I keep telling you, everywhere you look, it's all one giant lava field. 25 feet solid rock. It'll take jackhammers to...
I don't need a lecture, goddammit. I get it.
No, you don't. But these people are hungry. Even if they had all their strength. It'll take them months to finish this job with picks and shovels.
I don't give a shit! We're all hungry, Al. But this job's gotta get done, whether it takes all goddamn year. It's not like we got somewhere else to be now, do we?
Wait. Not finished.
We'll make it quick, will ya, Al? I got things to do.
Rippers. This morning, one of my men spotted a large group of them coming over the pass.
And no one stopped them?
How the f... Tucker, you know we're already spread thin.
Are they headed north? Al! Are they headed towards us? Yes or no?
I don't know. Maybe he knows.
What the fuck are you up to now, huh? What's this about, huh?
Damn it, Alki. It's not his job to know. It's your goddamn job to know.
I can't be at two places at one time. You either want me here, running your dig, or you want me out there in the shit. Chasing the Rippers.
Go check the store, see how much ammo we got left. I'll tell Wheeler to watch the dig.
What are you looking at?
Oh, I don't know, just waiting for you to smarten the fuck up.
Don't! Did you track down Leon? Good thing someone around here knows how to make things happen. Ride with me. How long's it been since you found someone, brought him in?
The kind of people left out in the shit aren't the kind of people you want me bringing in.
We lost two more to the fever.
It's not my problem.
You want our food? I'm making it your problem.
I told you, we'll do runs for you, but we're not joining your goddamn camp.
Remind me again, my old woman's memory. Why is that?
Because it's a waste of time, Tuck.
Well, aren't you the optimist? Where's Boozer?
He said he was gonna head over to Copeland's camp, see about trading for some fish.
You're not in bed with Cope now, are you? His camp near yours?
It's not closer or further. Look, I'm not Boozer's old lady. He goes where he wants.
I know we can't bury these because...
Jesus.
The people just dig them up.
Keep the shit burning all day and night.
Got a lot of freak corpses piling up out here. With men like you doing your jobs. Damn right we keep burning.
Try using more gasoline. Burns faster, less fumes.
Like we got so much to spare? When it's all gone, what are you gonna put in that bike of yours, spitting sweat? Now what the hell is going on here?
The count's off. Storage is missing food and some ammo.
Jesus. Who was on watch last night?
Wheeler.
Tonight, double the watch. This shit's starting to piss me off.
You got it.
Trouble in paradise.
It's like I was saying. Camp's like a prison. Bunch of goddamn lazy liars, thieves, rapists, and murderers. You know why that is?
No idea.
'Cause that's who we are. The freak show. Only folks survived were those mean enough, nasty enough to out-freak the freaks. The rest are here, hoping I feed them, protect them, keep them nice and cozy and warm, so they can sit on their asses and watch the world end. You! Get your ass back to work! Don't make me go get Cyrus! Lazy sons of bitches can screw around all they like on their time. Daytime is my time. Running this camp is no different than running a prison.
I can't remember what you said. You were what? You were a warden or something?
Nothing so high and mighty. I was matron of the women's ward. You look like the sort who might have spent some time in the pen back in the day. You ever do time?
I had my share of trouble, but I never landed in K-State.
I got a job for you. Larson was on a run yesterday. Passed through Marion Forks, said he saw someone. Young woman, looked like. But he only caught a glance. He stopped to look around, but he never found her.
Get back to work.
Is he sure?
Come on.
Larson's been doing this long as you. He knows a person from a freak.
No,
you got a knack for this. You head over there and find her before the freaks do.
Stop!
I'll see what I can do. But look, I want the rest of my credits for Leon.
You bring me warm bodies, I'll give you all the credits you can spend. I gotta go find Wheeler. Someone's looking at a night in the shack.
Alcott. What do you want, Drifter?
What's your problem?
One of my men escaped to Ripper Camp over by Iron Butte. Got tortured, like they always do. But this time, they kept asking me if you knew about it. Two men, asking me if you'd ever seen them or heard of them.
A lot of bikes around here. What's it got to do with me?
The Ripper called them mongrels. How many drifters still flying colors around here? As if that shit matters. If you ask me, you got a price on your head. How's it feel to be on the other side?
Now, why don't you just show me what you got, because I don't have time for your bullshit.
Whatever you say, Deke.
What else can I do for you? Yeah, all right. I'll be here.
I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to. We can't head north until I get this bike fixed up. Copeland, it is.
How's it going?
Just having a look.
Need gas? Stuff's getting scarce. I rode this one hard.
Get the lead out.
See you around.
Eat. Get back to work. Now.
How you doing?
How's life in the hot springs?
Need supplies, weapons. This will do you good out there. Here you go. Come by if you still need something. Later.
How's it going?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, you keeping busy?
I haven't seen Boozer around much lately.
Yeah, he's around. I guess he's just been doing more work for Copeland lately.
You tell him I said get off his ass and do some work for me.
Yeah, I'll let him know.
See you again. Yeah.
Hey, Deke, you there? I was thinking about heading down to that logging camp, clear out those nests, and see more freaks up here.
Boozer, no, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the mess, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight. Fewer freaks inside those nests.
Not safe out here in the shit. I know where there's a camp that...
No, where? Where? I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much. I thought I was gonna die in there.
Tell him it was St. John. Deacon. They know who I am. Stay off the main roads. Don't stop.
St. John, this is Copeland. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know you ride with him.
tried to radio him. Can't seem to reach him. If you see him, you can tell him to swing by and say hello to Copeland. Much appreciated. Copeland out.
Deacon St. John, you out there? We got a job for you here at the hot springs.
Doctor, okay, I'll head your way. St. John out. Finish burning out this infestation zone. Come back later and finish burning out these nests.
Open up, it's that drifter.
You feeling any better?
Deacon.
Me and a couple of guys in the nest a few months back. You know, freaker nest.
Hey, Cope. I think Liam was bringing you this.
Oh, Deke. You made a wise choice. Wise choice. You go see Manny. Maybe he can help you with that bike of yours.
You, need some... Man.
Manny, what's going on?
Need fuel? Bike's probably thirsty. This should last you for a while. Cool. Need anything else? Look me up if you need anything else. That bike of yours. Need some fuel? I'll get it fixed up for you. I'll be here. All right. Be seeing you. I used to be a
cop. I didn't think I'd see you around so much.
Farewell. Hey. Think we had a pretty good training
equipment. That all you need? Nice.
It wasn't just the looting, which started almost over.
Come by any time.
Just going nuts, shooting at anything that looked even a little crazy. Not realizing that they were just as bad.